Welcome to this Vue Spreadsheet component tutorial. In this video, I'll show you how easy it is to open and save Excel files in the Syncfusion Vue Spreadsheet component. I will also show you how to open an Excel file on the application's initial load, set up a server, and send custom parameters. First, I open my existing project where all the necessary spreadsheet modules are configured and the basic spreadsheet code added. Using the eSheet stack, I have mapped the data source to a specific range in a sheet. I have also customized the columns using the eColumns tag. To learn more about integrating this spreadsheet into a Vue application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application by running the npm run dev command. You can see that the spreadsheet is rendered with the provided data source. To import a file into the spreadsheet, you can use the Open option in the File menu. Using the Save As option, you can export the spreadsheet. Now let's see how to enable these options in the spreadsheet programmatically. First, I will import the Excel file into the spreadsheet using built-in APIs. To proceed, I must verify whether the Allow Open property is enabled, typically the default spreadsheet setting. Additionally, I need to invoke the Open API hosted at the service URL. In the data property, I add the Open URL variable and assign the Syncfusion service URL. Then assign this variable to the Open URL property. When I open the File menu, click the Open option and choose a file, the selected file is imported into the spreadsheet. Next, I will show you how to load an Excel file initially on a spreadsheet using the Open method. In the Created method, specify the URL of an online Excel file to fetch the Excel document and convert it to a blob. Then, convert the blob into a file and pass it to the spreadsheet open method as an argument. I'll remove data source from the ranges tag to clearly demonstrate this functionality. Look here, the spreadsheet loads the sample Excel file initially. Next, I will show you how to save the spreadsheet to Excel using an API. To proceed, I must verify whether the Allow Save property is enabled, typically the default spreadsheet setting. Additionally, I need to invoke the Save API hosted at the service URL. In the data property, I add the Save URL variable and assign the Web API service URL to save. Then assign this variable to the Save URL property. Now I save the file using the Save As option in the File menu. Files can be saved in different file formats such as XLSX, XLS, CSV, and PDF. I choose the XLSX format and save the file with the name sample. See here, the exported file is saved in the local folder. Next, I will demonstrate how to save a spreadsheet by clicking an external button. I plan to use the Syncfusion Vue button, so install it using the command npm install at Syncfusion EJ2 Vue buttons. Next, import the button component from the installed package and register the button component in the components property. I add the EJS button tag and the content save. And I also add the inline style with a margin of 5 pixels to align the button. As I said earlier, I save a file with a button click, so I add a click event with the callback method button click. Next, I define the button click method inside the methods property. And I call the built-in save method using the spreadsheet instance. I add the URL property and assign the Save API from the Syncfusion service URL as an argument, and set the file name as spreadsheet data. As mentioned earlier, files can be saved in different formats. I set the save type as PDF. When I click the Save button, the spreadsheet data is exported to a PDF document. Let me show you the server-side configuration for opening and saving spreadsheet. The spreadsheet supports Web API, ASP.NET Core, and MVC platform services for handling both import and export. Let me open the Web API server project and show the spreadsheet methods. This open method is defined to convert Excel files into a client-side spreadsheet model, which is then sent as JSON to render the spreadsheet. Notice the save method. The client-side spreadsheet model is sent to the server as JSON, where it will be processed and saved. I run this project. Now the project is successfully compiled. In my Vue project, I will use the hosted Web API links in the Open URL and Save URL properties. When I refresh the spreadsheet, the created event will be triggered, so the debugger hits the open method in the server project, and the sample Excel file is imported. When I try to save the file, the debugger hits the save method, and the spreadsheet will be exported to Excel. Finally, I will show you how to send custom parameters to the server. I add the before save event and assign the callback method on save. In the methods property, I define the onSave method to pass the custom parameters to the server. Here, pass the custom parameter in the arguments as format CSV. In the Web API project, change the Save API method by adding the custom parameter in the arguments to receive the details sent from the client side. Check now, when I save the spreadsheet as CSV file, the debugger hits the Save method, and the custom parameters are received on the server side. Let me recap. I showed you how to open and save Excel files in a Vue spreadsheet and a few basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link to see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our Vue products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.